get to the news. Yesterday was Father's Day, and if you forgot to call him, that's actually what he wanted. During a conservative conference in Florida last week, former Vice President Mike Pence was booed and called a, quote, traitor. And it takes an awful lot to make me feel bad for Mike Pence, because that didn't. That's right, Mike Pence was booed at a conservative conference in Florida. Of course, a few months ago, they were trying to kill him. Getting booed is the Mike Pence equivalent of a standing ovation. According to a new book, former President Trump suggested that Americans who were abroad and infected with the coronavirus should be sent to Guantanamo Bay so the number of cases would not increase. This brings us to our new segment. Seth discovers he can still experience shock. Huh. Even after everything, I mean, wow. Okay.
This has been Seth discovers he can still experience shock.
Republicans. Well, no one's going to be able to hear it. Oh, wait, the words are on the screen. Republican Senator Lindsey Graham said in an interview yesterday that if President Biden wants, quote, an infrastructure deal of $1 trillion, it's there for the taking. Added Graham, go on, it's right over there, under that crate, propped up with a stick. A New York City council candidate is receiving attention online after a video of him visiting a dominatrix was posted to Twitter. The whole incident was so humiliating, he gave the dominatrix an extra $1,000. Track legend Usain Bolt and his wife yesterday announced the birth of their twins, Saint and Thunderbolt, and you just have to feel for whichever of them came out second. The New York Times yesterday published a report detailing a lab analysis of Subway's tuna sandwich. They had a feeling something fishy wasn't going on. Nice one from Karen. Really edging into Goldish territory. Carnival Cruise Line told customers last week that a data breach may have exposed the personal information of employees and customers. So if you've been on a Carnival cruise recently, now you have a second problem. Lawmakers in Connecticut passed a bill last week to legalize the use of recreational marijuana. And just look at how many neck sweaters are already untied. And finally, according to a recent study, scientists believe a species of fish can have pregnancies that last up to 5 years, or more likely, she's playing you, bro. After an aide told former President Trump that there was no legal recourse to stop late-night comedy shows from making fun of him, Trump reportedly asked, quote, can something else be done about it? Well, Donald, I'm pleased to announce the answer is yes. Here is my offer. When Broadway comes back in the fall, you play Willie Loman in Death of a Salesman. That's it. That's all you have to do. If you play Willie Loman in Death of a Salesman, we will not make fun of you on late night for the rest of the year. But you have to be off book. If you forget your lines or more likely don't read the script in the first place, you just have to make something up. You just have to make up a plot of whatever you think Death of a Salesman is about. And if you're wondering what the catch is, there isn't one. This is just something I personally would really enjoy seeing. But if you don't do this, well, then I'm sorry, but it's Eclipse City in the graphics department, baby. The White House yesterday announced which countries will receive 55 million doses of the coronavirus vaccine, and they were pretty dramatic about it.
Argentina, Brazil, Colombia.
The Senate voted today on the For the People Voting Rights Bill. Republicans voted from the floor between 6 a.m. and 6 p.m., and Democrats voted at an elementary school 30 miles away between noon and 12:15 p.m. New York prosecutors are reportedly investigating if Trump Organization executive Matthew Calamari received tax-free benefits from the company. Prosecutors aren't sure if they really want Calamari or if he's just something to pick at while they wait for the main course. Do you get it? Or are you running lines for Death of a Salesman? Texas Governor Greg Abbott last week signed a bill into law allowing residents to carry a handgun without a license, so the next time the electrical grid collapses, you'll at least feel like you have power. During a teletown hall yesterday about the For the People Voting Rights Bill, former President Barack Obama urged Senate Republicans not to use the filibuster to block a vote on the legislation. Oh, yeah, well, I'm sure they'll listen to you. Why not have Hillary and the cast of Pose give him a call as well? President Biden is reportedly planning to announce a strategy to reduce gun violence this summer, but before you give him too much credit, The plan is free knives. In a new interview, Senator Joe Manchin described growing up in a big Italian Appalachian family and said, quote, I didn't care what color you were. I'm going to hug and kiss you first and then find out if we're related. I'd go further than that, said Rudy Giuliani. And again, I really need to hammer home this man married his cousin, his second cousin. He was married to a cousin, divorced her, and married a second cousin. Second cousin. But you believed it for a second. While campaigning yesterday, New York mayoral hopeful and Brooklyn Borough President Eric Adams called rival candidate Andrew Yang a fraud and a liar. And then Andrew Yang called Brooklyn Brookline. Am I saying that right? I think that's right. The members of the first U.S. Olympic skateboarding team were announced yesterday, though I'd probably remind them as it gets closer. Delta Airlines announced yesterday that it expects to hire over 1,000 pilots by next summer in order to meet the growing travel demand, though this isn't very reassuring. Amid a national shortage of chicken wings, restaurant chain Wingstop has launched an online brand selling chicken thighs called Thigh Stop. And things are even tougher over at Buffalo Wild Beaks. Las Vegas Raiders defensive end Carl Nassib yesterday became the first active NFL player in history to come out as gay. Said fans, what? The Raiders play in Vegas now? And finally, according to a new study, men who are unhappy in their marriages are at a higher risk of death. As for men who are happy in their marriages, why, they're dead already. The Senate voted yesterday to block the For the People Voting Rights Bill, but not until they got their voting paperwork in order. Let's see, I got my license, passport, tax returns, high school yearbook. Okay, I think I'm ready for my riddle. All 50 Senate Republicans voted yesterday to block the For the People Voting Rights Bill, but they did have a counteroffer. Republican Senator Mike Lee said in an interview yesterday with Fox News host Sean Hannity that the For the People Voting Rights Act was, quote, written in hell by the devil himself, which is also what it says on the poster for F9. The White House said yesterday that it will likely fall short of its goal of vaccinating 70% of U.S. adults by July 4th, but at least the announcement will be spectacular. Dr. Anthony Fauci said yesterday that the Delta variant of the coronavirus is, quote, unquestionably more transmissible than other common variants of COVID-19. All right, I feel like as a treat, we should let Fauci announce some good news. Doesn't even have to be science-based. The second season of Mayor of Easttown. Mayor's back, everybody. We're so excited. Just something so that when he shows up on TV, we aren't immediately like, now what? Did the COVID bat have babies? That's right, Dr. Anthony Fauci said yesterday that the Delta variant of the coronavirus is, quote, unquestionably more transmissible than other common variants of COVID-19. Unfortunately, it was tough to hear him over the Foo Fighters. New York held its Democratic mayoral primary yesterday, but due to the city's use of ranked choice voting, it will be several weeks before a winner is formally declared, said Eric Adams. Ugh, I gotta hang around the city for several weeks? A trade group representing U.S. Airlines this week called on the Justice Department to impose stricter punishments on unruly passengers, up to and including middle seats. In honor of actress Meryl Streep's 72nd birthday yesterday, fans changed New York City's 72nd Street subway station to say 72nd Streep. And then Streep won another Oscar for her reaction to that news. Oh, my God. This is such an honor. In honor of Cinema Week, AMC Theaters is offering customers an all-you-can-eat popcorn deal and an all-you-can-stand nacho deal. The amusement park at New York's Coney Island next month will unveil its new custom-made 68-foot-tall roller coaster, the Phoenix, though if you really want a thrill at Coney Island, get in the water. In a letter to the court, a woman who was charged with participating in the January attack on the Capitol told the judge that she learned the error of her ways by watching the movie Schindler's List, which she said, quote, was hard to watch. Okay, rude, said Steven Spielberg. And finally, today was National Pink Day, thanks to yet another gender reveal gone wrong. The former Trump lawyer Rudy Giuliani has been banned from practicing law in the state of New York. I object, said people at his wedding. You see, guys, Rudy Giuliani's wife, she wasn't, She wasn't a normal wife. She was, how do I explain? Okay, so you know how you have cousins? And then you know how you also have someone who's a wife and that's a different person? Rudy Giuliani was like, wouldn't it be more efficient if they could be both? Former President Trump reportedly told aides that he hoped the coronavirus would kill his ex-National Security Advisor, John Bolton. Luckily, Bolton had the wisdom to grow his own N95. He hasn't even had a cold since the 90s. That's right. Former President Trump reportedly told aides that he hoped the coronavirus would kill John Bolton. Oh, he was much more proactive with me, said Mike Pence. Chairman of the Joint Chiefs, General Mark Milley, yesterday criticized Republicans who opposed the U.S. Military Academy teaching critical race theory and said, quote, I've read Mao Zedong, I've read Karl Marx, I've read Lenin. That doesn't make me a communist. That's true, but it does make him really annoying at college parties. Republican Senator John Kennedy yesterday criticized President Biden's plan to address rising crime rates and said, quote, why is it safer to walk down the streets of Mogadishu than New York City? Well, that's easy. Mogadishu doesn't have Revel. Microsoft this week became the second U.S. company to reach a market value of $2 trillion. But remember, the first was GameStop. President Biden traveled to North Carolina today and visited a mobile vaccination site. It wasn't supposed to be mobile, but they saw him coming. Oh, man, he's going to tell one of his stories. Pick everything else. Pick everything up. Netflix has released a trailer for its new dating show called Sexy Beasts, which features people wearing animal masks and prosthetics to go on dates. But the show will face stiff competition from Just Going to Bed Already. And finally, today, soccer star Lionel Messi turned 34 years old! We're gonna take a long break. And that was a monologue, everybody!